गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, लेट्स प्रोसीड आवर चैप्टर दैट इज वर्क एंड एनर्जी एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी. बिफोर दिस क्लास आई हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट इज ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ एनर्जी. यस, एनर्जी कैन नाइदर बी क्रिएटेड नॉर बी डिस्ट्रॉयड बट इट इज ट्रांसफॉर्म फ्रॉम वन फॉर्म टू अनदर फॉर्म एंड वेरी सिंपल वी आर यूजिंग इन अ होम दैट इज आयरन. डेली वी आर यूजिंग आयरन, इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इज चेंजेस इन टू हीट एनर्जी. दैट एनर्जी इज कंजर्व्ड एंड सो आवर टॉपिक इज कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी. Conservation of energy states that energy can transform from one form to another, but the total energy remains constant. How we prove it? So today I am discussing only one case to prove this. Let us discuss the total energy for freely falling body. So first we try to understand what is mechanical energy. Mechanical energy is sum total of kinetic energy and potential energy. So I am writing mechanical energy ME, kinetic energy plus potential energy. And very common example, flying of aeroplane. Flying of aeroplane, it is at certain height means position, potential energy, and it is moving kinetic energy. And when total energy is considered, that energy is nothing but mechanical energy. Today we will see some cases that how this total energy remains constant. So this is your ground floor, ground body, keep some body here. Let this body is having mass m. When this body starts falling, let the total height be h. Position of the body we are denoting at height is a. Drop this body. When we leave this body or drop this body, let this body has came up to position b. Let this position b. Then what will be the height of this B? So first, let the body travels from A to B is X distance, X meter. Then naturally, when body will fall on the ground, suppose this position is C. So from B to C, the height will be H minus X. At every case A, B, C, let us find out the mechanical energy. So, I am starting now for case A. When the body is at A, what is the mechanical energy? I am writing in mechanical energy is also at A, that is kinetic energy at A plus potential energy at A. One by one, let us discuss. First, potential energy at A. We know the formula of potential energy. Mg, mass is m, g, acceleration due to gravity, and height we are having h. So, h. Then what about kinetic energy? Let us say this for case A. Solve the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is equal to half m v square. We have to find v square. We know from third equation of motion, v square minus u square is equal to 2gh. As the body was at rest, then v square is equal to that, or you can write minus 0 square is 2gh. So directly I am writing v square is equal to 2gh. Put the value of v square in kinetic energy. So what we will get this here, v square, the body is at position A, so naturally u is also 0 and v is also 0 because it is not moving. So your v square will become 0. It is not moving. So everything, body is at rest, that means it is not moving, means no velocity, so it is 0. So directly may I write half m into 0, because v is 0. So what we have got, 0 plus mgh, that is mgh. So mechanical energy at position A is mgh. You have got one case. Now what? Allow this mass to fall and this body has came at position B. So let us find out for position B what will be the mechanical energy. Again, I am writing mechanical energy at B is equal to kinetic energy at B plus potential energy at B. For this, both we have to find out. So one by one I am showing you. See, potential energy at B, we know formula mgh. Mg, what will be h? Because now the body has came at B. So in case of potential energy, always we see the height from the ground, because we have to find out the position, and position we are finding out from ground only, not from above. So generally we find height from the ground. So what we have got, h minus x. We have got potential energy. Then what about for this case kinetic energy? Kinetic energy is half m v square. And again from second equation of motion, v square minus u square is equal to 2gh. U, it was again, it was at rest. So directly I am writing v square minus v square is equal to 2gh. What is this h? H is the displacement, s. 2gs, that only I have written h. So h is the displacement from where the body has started moving. So how much distance it has moved? It has moved x distance. So we can write this one as v square is equal to 2gx, because h is the displacement and it has traveled x distance. By putting the v square in kinetic energy, we will get half m into 2gx. So let's find out the mechanical energy for this case. Kinetic energy we have got for this case is half m into 2gx plus potential energy we have got mgh minus x. Let us open the bracket. We will get it. This I am writing over here. So you see, mechanical energy at B, half m into 2gx plus mg h minus mgx. जी एच माइनस एम जी एक्स एंड सो कट एम जी एक्स एंड नाउ यू सी अगेन वी हैव गॉट एम जी एच. सो पोटेंशियल एनर्जी एट बी इज इक्वल टू एम जी एच. You have you seen in first case A we have got mgh, second case B are we are getting mgh. That means total energy remains constant, only transform takes place. When body was at A, potential energy was there. When start moving, this potential energy is slowly changing into kinetic energy, and so at each position we are getting mgh. Now allow the body to fall on ground, just ground means just little bit above the ground. So let us see when it fall on the ground what will be its mechanical energy. Body has fallen and came at position C. So I am writing mechanical energy at C is equal to potential energy at C plus kinetic energy at C. Potential energy at C, I am writing formula mgh for potential energy. Kinetic energy is half mv square. Let us find out h first one, height. The body has fallen just above the ground. Height is almost zero. Height is almost zero. So we can write mg into zero plus half m v square. What we are getting half m v square here? Calculate the v square. V square minus u square is equal to 2 g s. So u was zero because it initially the velocity was zero. V square is equal to 2g. Now s, displacement, what is, how much the body has displaced? The body has displaced from point A to point C and it covers h distance, so we are writing h. So kinetic energy half m and v square is into 2g h. Put this value in the equation. So what we are getting, mg into 0, that is 0 plus half m into 2g h, 2 cancelled. So we have got mg h. So mechanical energy at C is also mg h. You have seen the total energy remains constant. At position A, it is mgh. At position B, it is mgh. At position C, it is mgh. So, in any process, energy is transformed, but total energy remains constant. So, student, you make your notes by seeing the video. Okay.